During the Cretaceous period, dinosaurs could be found on every continent across the world. They even conquered the most extraordinary environment of all, the South Pole. A great example of a polar dinosaur is Leaellynasaura amicagraphica. It was a specialist living in southern Victoria, and it was perfectly adapted to living in these harsh conditions. It was cute, it was Australian, and it was unique. My name's Andrew, and you're watching Prehistoric Australia. Today, we're going to be delving into the frozen world of Leaellynasaura. Now, paleontologists knew that any dinosaurs living in southern Victoria would be special. And Leaellynasaura fossils have been found on the Otway coast of southern Victoria in the Umarala Formation. These rocks date back to between 115 and 110 million years ago in the early Cretaceous period. At this time, Australia was positioned much further south, and southern Victoria was within the Antarctic Circle. Now here, there was a rift valley connecting Australia to Antarctica. And this was the home of Leaellynasaura. Much like our modern world, Leaellynasaura would have undergone annual struggles. During the winter, it would have undergone darkness and freezing temperatures for up to 24 hours a day for 3 months of the year. And during the summer, it would have undergone 24-hour daylight for up to 3 months of the year. These polar dinosaurs survived and thrived despite the seasonal extremes. So, how did Leaellynasaura do it? Well, it had a few unique adaptations up its sleeve. If you travel back to the early Cretaceous period and you saw a little Leaellynasaura running about, you'd probably think you'd just seen a wild turkey. It measured around 1 meter long and was about 40 centimeters high. And even if it wasn't the size of a turkey, it wouldn't harm you anyway. It was a herbivore. We know that from the shape of its teeth. It would have fed on low-growing plants such as ferns and horsetails. Let's be honest, this dinosaur is pretty unassuming to look at. Upon first impressions, you wouldn't think it was anything special, but you'd be wrong. The most distinctive feature of Leaellynasaura was its large eyes. With these enormous light-sensitive eyes, it would have allowed it to continue foraging for food in the dark winter months. We know this because we have a fossilized skull of Leaellynasaura, and it clearly shows the large eye sockets this animal would have had in life. An endocast also shows the preserved impression of the top of the brain. Here, two bumps in the impression clearly show the optic lobe of the brain. Now, the optic lobe is the part of the brain that receives signals from the eyes. And the fact that these optic lobes are large indicates that this animal might have seen in the dark. However, all these unique features could just point to Leaellynasaura being a juvenile specimen. You see, in nature, juveniles often have big eyes in proportion to the size of their heads. And as they grow up, as adults, their heads become bigger and their eyes appear more normal sized. So for dinosaurs like Leaellynasaura, this could have just been the phenomenon that occurred to them as well. For this reason, perhaps these large eyes weren't an adaptation for seeing in the dark at all. They could have just belonged to a juvenile specimen of Leaellynasaura. Did Leaellynasaura have feathers? Extraordinary evidence of dinosaurs being covered in feathers has been turning up all over the world, except Australia, until now. Since 1962, 10 fossilized feathers have been discovered in the Coomera fossil bed in Victoria. The rocks here date back 118 million years. Fast forward to 2020, a paper published in Science Direct finally recognized the significance of these rare finds. In particular, the paper describes the first ever non-avian dinosaur feathers found within the Antarctic Circle. Most likely, these are body feathers of a small carnivorous theropod, like a raptor. Some of these feature what may be patterning or camouflage. Inside the feathers, dark coloration and branching structures for insulation may have helped conserve warmth during the dark winters. So far, no one has yet found the body of a fossil dinosaur with feathers intact in polar Gondwana. But now we know it's possible, here's hoping that soon we'll find an amazing discovery that will confirm this definitively. The fact remains though that there is still no direct evidence that Leaellynasaura had feathers. So why do paleo artists continue to depict it with feathers? Well, there is possible evidence using a special technique known as phylogenetic bracketing. Basically, if an ancestor had a particular trait, providing it was beneficial, the descendant would probably have it too. So, based on phylogenetic bracketing, does Leaellynasaura have an ancestor or an ancestral cousin which possessed feathers as a trait? Well, yes. In 2014, a new species was announced. Calindrodromius zabakalicus. I think I said that right. An early Neornithischian dinosaur covered in proto-feathers. It lived in Siberia during the Jurassic period, around 168 million years ago. Leaellynasaura is somewhat of a descendant. It also belongs to the clade Ornithischia and is currently broadly classified under Ornithopoda, although this is heavily debated. The point is that an ancestral cousin of Leaellynasaura possessed feather-like structures. So would it be reasonable to assume that Leaellynasaura might also have possessed feathers to live in a cold climate? Well, yes, quite likely. So although scientists are yet to find absolute proof that Leaellynasaura had feathers, all lines of current evidence point to Leaellynasaura having a lovely coat of feathers. So what was it like growing up as a little cute baby Leaellynasaura? Well, according to paleontologists, it wasn't a baby for very long. Leaellynasaura grew up very fast. We know this because the internal structure of leg bones belonging to Leaellynasaura and other small ornithopods have been analysed. International scientist Holly Woodward teamed up with Australian scientists Tom Rich and Patricia Vickers-Rich. In their first study published in 2011, they wanted to know if the growth rates of Victoria's polar dinosaurs were different from that of dinosaurs in warmer parts of the world. They identified annually forming growth rings inside the structure of the limb bones. These bones had no lines of arrested growth, or lags, to indicate either winter hibernation or slowed growth caused by a decreased food supply. Instead, it seems that Leaellynasaura was active all year round, including throughout the winter seasons. The results of the second study, published in 2018, seemed to corroborate these finds. In this study, they wanted to find out more about the life history, or ontogeny, of these polar dinosaurs. By studying the bone tissue of 17 individuals, they discovered that all of these different dinosaur species across time grew very quickly during the first 2 to 3 years of their lives. Their skeletons reached maturity at 5 to 7 years. Then they continued growing at a steady pace for the rest of their life. This seems to have been a common and successful survival strategy among different species of Victorian dinosaurs. Growth rings can tell us a lot about the early years of these extraordinary dinosaurs. We know from overwhelming evidence across the world that non-avian dinosaurs grew very quickly, from infant to adulthood, and Leaellynasaura was no different. If you're Leaellynasaura in the middle of a forest that is frozen and snowed under, you probably wouldn't want to spend the night sleeping outside. Instead, you could be sleeping in a nice warm burrow underground. And there is evidence of this behaviour found in southern Victoria, close to where Leaellynasaura was found. In 1980, Tony Martin was exploring a remote part of the Otway coast when he discovered the first evidence of dinosaur burrows in Australia. The rocks where the fossilised burrows were found date back to the same time where Leaellynasaura lived during the early Cretaceous. Martin was confident that these rock formations were burrows because they were very similar in structure to a burrow he described in the United States. Found in Montana in the USA, the burrow that Martin had found contained dinosaur bones within it, specifically belonging to small ornithopods. Small ornithopods just like Leaellynasaura. The connection is uncanny. Burrows would have been crucial for the survival of dinosaurs during winter, that were too small to migrate, functioning as a warmer place to sleep, a safe haven from predators, and possibly even a nest to raise the next generation. Burrowing behaviour is a highly likely explanation for how small dinosaurs like Leaellynasaura would have survived the harsh winters of southern Victoria. Having a long tail was common amongst dinosaurs, from the long-necked sauropods to the meat-eating theropods, but none of them held the record for the longest tail relative to body size. That title went to, you guessed it, Leaellynasaura. According to the estimates of early studies, this little dinosaur's tail would have contained over 70 vertebrae and made up 75% of its total body length. That's more vertebrae than most other dinosaur tails, apart from hadrosaurs and sauropods. Like, wow. But what was its enormous tail even used for, especially when it needed to conserve body heat in the middle of cold weather? Well, as we discussed before, the tail is highly likely to have been covered in a coat of feathers. So some have speculated that it may have wrapped its long and fluffy tail around its body, enduring cold snaps during winters. Proof of this flexible tail comes from a 2009 paper by Matthew Charles Hearn from the University of Queensland, in which he argued that Leaellynasaura was also unusual amongst ornithischians of the time because it lacked ossified tendons in its tail. Ossified tendons are basically when tendons turn to bone. This made the tails of most ornithischian dinosaurs quite rigid, which held weight more effectively, but not the little Leaellynasaura. Lacking this feature meant its tail would have been quite flexible. So all this early research suggested that Leaellynasaura had a super long, super fluffy, super flexible tail. I mean, I would love to have that superpower. It is worth noting that there has been considerable scientific debate about exactly which fossil bones belong to Leaellynasaura amicagraphica. In 2013, Matthew Hearn decided to look back at that old fossil data. In his comprehensive investigation, he couldn't confidently assign the tail to the original specimen. A number of other fossil remains that were originally assigned to Leaellynasaura are currently under scrutiny. But that's the exciting thing about paleontology. When current evidence is questioned by scientists and new evidence comes to light, a brand new image forms about what these prehistoric animals were like in life. So our understanding of creatures such as Leaellynasaura may be dramatically different in the near future. And that's really exciting. Thanks to the discoveries led by Tom and Patricia Vickers-Rich, Leaellynasaura showcased the adaptability of dinosaurs. There was no environment they couldn't conquer, even thriving in a polar habitat thanks to some unique adaptations. Based on recent studies, the strongest lines of evidence for Leaellynasaura are its herbivorous teeth, small size, fast growth rate, and a coat of feathers. The less certain lines of evidence are the big eyes, the super long tail, and the burrowing behaviour. As a result, Leaellynasaura may have looked less like this, and maybe more like this. But what is certain is that Leaellynasaura was surely one of the cutest Aussie dinosaurs. Some people are cat people, some people are dog people, but at least your pets aren't extinct. I would love to have a pet like Leaellynasaura if I could. Alas, I can't. What dinosaur would you have as a pet if you could? Leave a comment below and let us know. Feel free to support us on Patreon. The link is in the description below. To show our appreciation, bonus content will be offered to everyone who signs up. Also, feel free to like and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to receive more content from Prehistoric Australia. Thank you.